What's up guys, it's Crafty Fox, and today I'm going to show you how to build Gordon from Thomas and Friends. So this is Gordon, and he's a big blue express train on the island of Sodor, and he's one of the fastest ones also. You can see he has really huge wheels, they're like 4 blocks tall compared to everyone else's, but yeah, that's what makes him big, and I got on a request to do this a lot, so I decided I really need to make this video. Alright, so let's get started. Alright, let's make his buffers. We're gonna place this red wool block 3 blocks above the tracks. And then on either side you want to add a piston. And then a lever in the middle, pull it down. And this is the front buffers. Just add red wool to the sides. Then let's add acacia wood slab underneath. Like that. And let's take some red wool, make the border of this. We're gonna make this 3 blocks long like that. And then we wanna go up a bit for the next one. And we want to make this 24 blocks long. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Alright, so after the 24th one, there is 6 block one. So let's go down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's do the other side as well. You want to match it up. And after that, let's go back to the front, work on that area. We're gonna take gray wool and just add that to the floor, I guess. Man, this is a really big engine, so you gotta fill in a lot of it. And once you're done with that, let's take some blue wool. Do we even need blue wool right now? I don't know. Let's do this cab. So we're gonna add a wall here, 3 blocks tall. Just go above this expansion area. And you want to make 3 pillars like this. And you leave the back alone. And make the pillars 2 blocks tall. And let's add 4 blocks on top going horizontal like that. And here in the corner we want to add a black stained glass. This is for the window that is on the side. And I think that's the last time we'll need the glass. And let's add nether brick stairs. Add that to the top at the sides of it like that. Then we're gonna take some light blue wool, just go across over here on the roof. And then we're gonna use a nether brick slab, just add that along the roof. And have 1 block sticking out like that. And then we're gonna lay on top of that some black carpet so that we can make it one color. Alright, so once you're done with that, let's work on the rest of the engine. Now it's gonna take a while, it's kinda complicated. So let's start off with this front wheel. But then we also need to make these things in the middle. So I guess we just skip this block here. Just add. Let's add a miller. I mean a middle column. Just add a gray wool. Just to keep the wheels in place. And we're gonna go back. Until this area here. Where it goes down. That's when it goes up. So when we come up to this part, in front of the cab, we want to make one block missing over here, so it looks like it's going upwards. And let's make the front wheels. Now these are the tiny ones. I think they're called the lead wheels. And yeah, we just place it one right next to this gray wall. So I'm just doing the top first. And then we want to use the bottom. And then let's add the other wheel, which there's two blocks of space. So over here, I should have done these two sides at the same time, but oh well. Skip to add right here. Okay, we got the lead wheels. And then the driving wheels. We have three of driving wheels. Or, not three, six. So there's three blocks of space. Then that's where the driving wheels start. So we're going to skip three. So one, two, three. And this is where the driving wheel is. And the driving wheel is pretty huge. And the top part is covered in my bottle. Although I think in the model, the actual show, you could actually see a bit of the top, but for mine, you can't, which is kind of unfortunate. So we're just going to add stonework stairs in the corners here. And yeah, that's pretty much all you see of the blue wheel. And there's going to be a block of space between each one, so you just want to copy that same design. It's just four blocks wide, and we have stonework stairs in the corners of it, and I'm just doing just this side for now. Alright, so let's copy that over. The same technique, so skip three here, and then we want four blocks wide, so let me do just the top ones, the top section. Then the bottom. Let's add the curves, which are the stone brick stairs. And over here, there's a tiny wheel. And that's like, let me count one, two, three. So three blocks away. Right over here, this area, it's where we're gonna make it. Actually, let's put a gray wall in the middle here so it's easier to place. Let's add stone brick stairs. Like that, and that's our trailing wheel. And now let's go move on to the front again. Let's add another brick stairs right after the buffers, so right here. Then let's take some black wool, which I don't have right now for some reason, and just add one over here. And you don't have to worry about, actually you do, so let's add that anyways. And let's add black carpet on top of the black wool to make it more pop out more, I mean. Alright, let's take stone brick slab, just add that over here. I think one in there, yeah, one in between the black wool. And let's take another brick fence. Add these lamp rods. I think that's what they're called, because they hold on the lamps. And the lamp is represented just by this block of quartz. I mean, sometimes they have it, sometimes they don't. Alright, and let's work on the face now. So the face is just really huge compared to everyone else. And this is what it looks like. So three down here. And you want to make this kind of circle shape. Like that. And just fill it in with quartz. So look at that face compared to everyone else. And yeah, let's add more black wool. And we want to add four black walls after that, filling in this whole area. I think Henry actually looks a lot like Gordon, just with a bit of, he's a bit more boxy, I think. Anyways, let's move on to the funnel. Just add these two black walls on top like that. Alright, so let's add some more detail to make him look more normal, because right now it looks weird. Just add this piston cover thing right over here. Is that 2x2? So we're gonna leave that space alone for now. And actually, if you want to, we can add some gray wool over here. Cover it up some area. Right before, we want to leave a block of space before the front driving wheel. Like that. And let's take some skeleton skulls and just add that in the front of the cover. And we should probably make the pistons now. And this is what the pistons look like. Or not the piston, the, I mean it is, but the rod? Something something rod, okay? I don't know the terminology. Alright, we're gonna make this line of stone brick going across over here to like about here of the first wheel. Yeah, like right after the middle. And then we're gonna add these two stone brick over here and continue the line till we reach that, the middle of the second driving wheel. And then we're gonna go to the last one. Yeah, we should connect that to the middle of the last wheel. And for the bottom part over here, we just go across all the way like that. And we're just gonna add these stone brick column over here, three blocks like that. And let's see, I think that's about it, right? Yeah, so that's how you make the coupling rods. Yeah, I think that's what they're called. And let's do this side as well, just the same exact design. Wait, how far does this go? To the first wheel, in the middle of the first wheel, and then we're gonna add going downwards, I guess. Goes to the second wheel, and this one just goes across to the third wheel, like over here, going all the way across. Connect this and then add three under it in the front, and that should be the coupling rods, which wasn't so bad. Alright, so let's work on I don't know what this is called, his body. So I'm just gonna add some, is this light blue wool? Just behind his face, just continue that shape all the way to the back. I guess this is like a giant water tank. That's what I imagine it to be. I think you burn the water to start the engine, and that's why Gordon has a giant body just to fill in all the water so he can have more power, I guess. And anyways, let's move on to the next step. Let's take an oak fence, just add that to the front of the cab in the middle. And that's gonna be Gordon's whistle. And let's add that little dome on top. And this is right above the middle driving wheel. So just go up here, bam. It should align like that. And what else? Let's add some more detail to the front and the sides, which is this light gray carpet, and we're just gonna add that to all the exposed red parts, or these pistons over here. Just add that bit, three on that side, and we need to add these covers too, so that looks, we add stone brick stairs over here. And then we're gonna have a cover for each of the driving wheels, so it should look like that. So to make a cover, you should put two light blue wool in the centers at the top. And then we're gonna add a stone brick slab next to it. So then we get the shape right here. And let's do that to the other side as well. Just align it up. Then we're gonna add the stone brick slabs. And then let's continue this light gray carpet covering all the exposed red wool on top. And then let's add this light blue wool over here. Just fill in that so there's only one light gray wool carpet here. Alright. So that's the front of Gordon. And of course he has a big tender box. Or not a tender, just a... Not a tender box, just a tender. Okay, let's add the stairs to get up to him. Just right after this red wool, add upside down stone brick stairs, make it double. And let's add stone brick slab on the bottom of it to add the lower step of the ladder. And let's start to make his tender. Now his tender is like 12 blocks long, not including the red wool, so just take the light blue wool, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then let's take red wool, make the back buffers, like it's the same every time, just pistons, lever, and make sure you pull it down so it sticks out. And let's add another brick fence over here. Put it on top of that piston. Just get that detail. Let's get a red carpet, which I don't have, so I'm gonna grab that. And just cover it up a little bit. And let's make the rest of the tender. So I'm just filling in the walls. And this should be like 4 blocks tall. So just adding 3 more layers. If you guys know what that nether brick fence is, can you tell me in the comments below? Because I have no idea why they have it. Like, there's this wire in the back of Gordon. And sometimes it's in the front of some engines. But I have no idea what it's for. Let's add a lamp in the back. Just represented by that quartz. And let's add some wheels to the tender. Get some gray wool just so we have something the wheels can grab onto. So one block away from here. Alright, so go over. Oh yeah, we need a I forgot we need a floor for this tender, or all the coal is gonna fall out. Then let's add the middle. Yeah, you could just fill it all in right here. We get skip this one here, then fill in a middle row of gray wool. Want to skip this part, and the wheels are the small wheels, the same design as the ones in the front. So we're just gonna take stone brick stairs, and it's 2 blocks apart from each other, and the first one starts right at this gray wool. So let me just make this top half first. Right now, let's. Right, cool. And let's add the bottom half. Once you get one corner of the bottom, the other corner is so easy to put in. Like that. And wait. Like that. Okay, now we have our tender wheels. And let's add more detail to the tender. There's like this kind of slope thing. And don't forget, there's like this, I guess it's a doorway. Just make it go in a bit. In a bit, and you can be able to go inside. Alright, let's add the slope, and that's like right here it starts, so just make that L shape right there. In the back, just continue the slope, it's a diagonal one, and let's connect it in the middle like that. And later we're gonna add the walls for the coal so it doesn't fall out. And this side, it has a black wall, which is like right here, like that. And let's grab some coal. Just fill in the top all the way with coal. And I guess if you want to make it realistic, maybe you could put some coal coming out of the tender like that. But I'm not sure what the interior of Gordon is, at least of the tender. And we need to add that banner if you want some more detail, so let's make the banner. Alright, so if you want to make Gordon's number, first off we're going to take some light blue banner, add a dandelion yellow column on the left, then we're going to take light blue dye, just add a 2x3 at the bottom, like that. Then we're going to go across in the middle, make a row of yellow, and then we're gonna add a column on the right. Now we have a number 4, and let's add a border of light blue dye, and there we have it, the light blue banner. So it looks exactly the same, and we're gonna place it on his tender because that's where he has it, right above this wheel, a big 4, and on this side as well, so that it matches. So that's how you build Gordon from Thomas and Friends. I hope you guys enjoyed that video, and if you did, hit that like button below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe because I will upload more videos in the future. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.